As you can probably imagine, the Tokimurui M9 Albert Wesker Model 01 Samurai Edge GBB pistol was heavily featured in the latest and scariest of the gaming franchise, Biohazard Resident Evil 7. Murui do have the license to produce these models, so you'd expect this pistol to be an exact replica with no exceptions. Internally, it's the same as all their previous models. Externally, however, Murui have given it a fancy makeover and sent it off to a Halloween-themed zombie-killing party. But is it too fancy? I've always been a fan of the classic M9 design, but this beefed up replica is actually relatively pretty. But let's get one thing out of the way. Since it's made by Tokimurui, you can tell that it is obviously made out of, you've guessed it, plastic. But that hasn't stopped folks from buying their products anyway. Speaking of which, only a certain group of people will actually be interested in purchasing this product. A, people who are fans of the game, or B, people who find this pistol generally badass looking. The pistol arrives in this case, Umbrella Corp logo at the front, and untidy diagrams at the back. Would I bring a case like this to a game? No! I would remove the cover and leave that at home. And underneath that blindingly bright cover is a case like this. I know you'll find a sticker on the side and on the front, but at least it doesn't take up the entire thing. And I'm a big fan of this little compartment for the handles, making it easier for storage. But let's take a look inside. Once you lift up the box, you'll find the pistol itself, the rail stabilizer, the light module, the octagonal mock suppressor, a 26-round chrome magazine, and the tiny box of useful bits and bobs. Now I say useful, because inside are magazine followers, a replacement front end for the rail stabilizer, so you don't have to have that 14mm CCW thread attached. Also, the best bag of BBs in the world, and finally, LR44 button cell type batteries for the light module. Underneath this foam padding is a manual that only 5% of the entire world will actually read, and a tiny Ziploc bag of plugs and hex keys. So, let's start putting it together, shall we? Once you take the light module, turn it upside down, and on the base is a button that opens up the battery compartment. That's where you insert said battery. Once you have, you can start attaching that to the rail stabilizer. But first, you'll need to remove this screw. Slide it onto the rail and put it back together. Now for the very familiar looking octagonal suppressor. You can attach it when the rail system is actually on the gun itself, but I'm going to attach it now. Just screw it onto the 14mm CCW thread. As you can see, it doesn't screw all the way, so you need to turn it back, lower the lever, fit it in tightly, and close it. Trust Murui to make it a little easier. The mock suppressor does not have an inner barrel, but enough of that, let's put it all together. Slide this section forward, fit it on the pistol, and lock it back. And here it is, the pistol in all its glory. I'm glad it has a 14mm CCW thread, because if you're not a fan of this style of suppressor, you could always remove it. Obviously, I'm not compensating for anything. That's a pun in itself. But when you have a suppressor on, make sure it sits flushed with the rail system or it's blocking the front and rear sights. Let's change it back. Look at how flush it sits, and there's hardly any suppressor wobble. Why is the light changing? Stupid zombies. The light module and the mock suppressor are still incredibly light, so it's not that front heavy at all. The grainy and diamond texture on the side panels and the surroundings offer plenty of grip. The police stars, raccoon logo, the wooden looking grip, and the markings on the slide, not taking into account the Tokyo Marui logo, replicates the game versions to a T. The serrations on the slide help with racking. It's got a functional decocker, slash safety, and I do like the fact that the mod suppressor does not interfere with the tri-dot affair. All in all, this thing is quite the beast, but you're probably wondering how one would adjust the hop with all this interference. Honestly, it's not that difficult. That switch on the rail, just push that forward, sliding off the entire thing. See, no fuss at all. Release the mag, pull the slide back, press this button, pull this lever down, push the slide forward, and this is where you adjust the hop. I think that's everything. Bob's your uncle, Fanny's your aunt, and Trevor's your second cousin. And does anybody have the time? Because I think it's time to chrono the thing. I'm going to make an assumption. My guess is that it'll chrono around 300 to 310. Any less and any more than that, probably surprise me. For the chrono test, I'll be using 0.2 gram 6mm BBs with green gas. Honestly, I'm genuinely surprised. Let's move on. Welcome to my makeshift CQB range test. I'm about 10 meters away, and yes, I could most definitely hit the target from here, but I want to see how tight the grouping can actually be. What's with the strange lighting? Hold on, let me get my suppressor. Alright, so let's bring that target over here. Now that I've had a closer look at the target, I can let you know that the grouping is about 2 inches apart with one deviation. And since that mock suppressor does not have an inner barrel, it won't interfere with the grouping. The M9 is a double action pistol, so the initial trigger pull is relatively long. But it's snappy. And the reset is pronounced, with a very short pull afterwards. But if I'm being honest here, it feels very much like every other Tokyo Marui pistol out there, which leaves me feeling rather meh in terms of how it handles. But what more than makes up for it is the fact that it actually jumped out of a game into my hands, a game that I played no longer than a week ago. It makes me want to go out there and shoot a few zombies in the face. Stupid zombies. Now there are quite a few different versions out there. Marck reviewed the 20th anniversary tan version here, and quite a few years back I reviewed the Barry Burton and the Jill Valentine model. And to watch these reviews, click on these specific links. Sure, you can take this to a regular game, in which case I'd prefer to buy a regular M9 because it's a fair bit cheaper. But if you buy the entire set, and imagine this, you can form an entire cosplay team and run together, you know, before they all decided to split up. All you really need to do is wear full black, throw on some shades, and ta-da, you are Albert Wesker. Guys, let me know in the comments section below, would you cosplay with this, would you take it to a skirmish, or would you do both? So for this cool product and many more, go to our online store at www.redwolfairsoft.com and see you guys on the next episode of RedWolf TV. Porn stash out.